I love this river. It's alive. It's constantly changing. It's very powerful. I'm Mike Anderson with the USGS Nebraska Water Science Center. We have Logan and Nathan, and today we're out on the Platte River at Watershed, Nebraska, doing an ice discharge measurement. This site has been operated for 24 years. It's one of nine sites that we stream gauge along the Platte River. So first thing we're gonna do is we'll drill a hole to define ice thickness and the depth of the water below the ice. We'll use an ADCP to collect velocity data under the ice. 0.8 tenths of a foot. And I'll use the ADCP, collect velocity data for 40 seconds. I've seen it at its worst in flooding situations and in ice breakup. I've seen ice sheets, ice cakes larger than cars come floating down the river. During floods, I've seen cottonwood trees, full-size cottonwood trees come, and you realize how small you are and how powerful this river can be.
Like a sandbox.
Jeez, what are they gonna do with all this? Where do you even start?
Platte River sand. I'm Jason Lambrecht. I'm the Associate Director for Hydrologic Data in Nebraska at the U.S. Geological Survey, the Nebraska Water Science Center out of Lincoln. We're at the boat landing on the Platte River by Lashara. The water level, the gauge height as we measure, is at about 6.7 feet today. During the flood that recently came through here, maybe 4 days ago, it went up to about 12 foot, and base flow around here, or base level here, is a couple feet below this, closer to 4.5 to 5. This discharge data is used by the Weather Service and the Corps and the emergency managers, the counties, the cities, the fishermen. Everybody looks at our, needs our data to know what's the water doing, how much water there is, what's the level of the water. See the high water marks right here?
Oh yeah.
The scar lines on the trees all around this area too are
pretty incredible.
Haunting. Hopefully the trees can survive this.
My name's David Pearson. I'm the service hydrologist with the National Weather Service in Omaha. The 2019 flood has been caused by several factors, specifically frozen ground, snowpack melt, and rainfall. Those three factors combined led to this dramatic and historic flooding. The USGS stream gauges undoubtedly save lives during this event. And there's no way to know how high a river is unless you have a river gauge on it. And that information is what we use to alert people to get out if there's flooding. And as this water leaves Nebraska and Iowa, it'll work its way down to Missouri and on downstream. And National Weather Service offices and forecast centers will be watching that as well and issuing warnings as needed. We try and give as much lead time as possible, and there probably is never enough. Our goal is to hopefully people don't get caught by surprise and we can provide ample time to evacuate.